Hey there, growers. I'm Dylen, and welcome back to another episode of Grow Positive.
Today, as you can see, we have a lot of stuff on the desk. We're going to be going over a harvest guide. So first up, we're going to talk about smell-proof bags. And these bags are great not only for storing, but also for transporting if you're going from your cultivation site to a dispensary or from cultivation site to cultivation site, wherever you need. And the company that I really like is called Revelry. We have a couple of their products right here, obviously their backpack. And then this is one of their big duffel bags. It's called the Continental. Each product, most of the products, I believe, have a little hidden compartment in there. Like the backpack has one in the front on the inside. This has one on the inside as well. But they have a wide range of sizes that'll fit all of your needs, even down to a little small wallet. I mean, they have hard cases. They have a hard case with a roller on it. They have a bunch of different products. And like I said, I really like these because not only are they made really well, they also look really cool. I mean, they have a bunch of different designs, a bunch of styles. I mean, I use my overnighter duffel bag as just a gym bag. So you can use it however you'd like. So next up, we're gonna be talking about vacuum seal bags and vacuum sealers. And as you can see, there's a few different options that I brought up, but there are even more than that. So you have the shield and seal, which I've used before, probably the most commonly known brand. But then you have Symbus. This actually just came to Monster Gardens. Not only do they have vacuum sealed bags, but they have their own vacuum sealer. And then as well, the Nature Vac vacuum sealed bags, and they make a vacuum sealer as well. You'll notice that they not only come in various sizes, colors, and even the actual sealers themselves come in various sizes. The one thing I will say is personally, when I was using them, I preferred the all black bags, just because if you're storing or even transporting, you're going to have a little bit of light degradation if you get a black on a clear or just an all clear bag. This is all personal preference, but I preferred to have an all black bag just to prevent any type of light degradation. But as you can see, lots of choices for you, for whatever fits your budget. So up next is gonna be how you're going to be containing your product. First off, wide variety of scales. First one being up to 1,000 grams capacity, and then the second, much larger scale, 5,000 grams capacity. After that, you're gonna go with tried and true turkey bags. You can go to True Liberty, or you could go to the Green Scissor. Either way, I mean, this is what I used a good amount of time, just turkey bags, if you're not going to be having to store them for long periods of time. And even if you are storing them for, you know, a little while, I always used to throw in a humidity pack, whether it be from Bavita or from Integra. Either way, you're going to want to, modulate the humidity that's going to be in this turkey bag. And this is even after the curing process. So all of these things, you're going to want to make sure to utilize at least some of them to, store and contain any of your product. So this would be kind of your sifting or general trimming section. First and foremost, you have the trim tray. Always love this product, been around for a few years. I still own one of the first ones of these, actually. I love this because you can just sit, you know, if you're trimming at home or at a facility, you know, listening to music, whatever you're doing, you can just kind of hang out. Trim on there, and it also has a micron screen, 150 micron screen in here, so you get a good amount of keef as well. I think it even comes with a brush. You just brush off the screen and make sure everything's as clean as possible. And then you have, this is another sifter I recently saw, haven't used a specific one, but it looks like a good idea. And it's very basic, straightforward. It starts off at a higher grid, or at least a larger grid, and then just keeps getting smaller, to where at the bottom, the very last one down here, is also, I would assume, 150 microns. It's usually the standard for most keef collection or any type of, concentrated trichome collection. It's 150 microns. So that seems like a good idea. Just kind of sift it out, keep your bigs, keep your middles, and then keep your smalls at the very bottom, and then, you know, go through the, get the trim and then get the keef. Similar idea. This one is designed for a 5-gallon bucket. So, you know, dump your product on here after you're done trimming or before, whatever you prefer. Kind of give it a little shake, make sure everything goes through to the bottom. Then you have your bigs on there, have your smalls, or have your larf in the 5-gallon bucket. Now, this is a new product. We're actually going to be doing a grow closet video on this product as well. I have yet to use this, but when I was told about this, I started geeking out. Really cool, really straightforward though. Put all your product in here. If you're like me and have a scale that's too small for a turkey bag or anything like that, you can put this on there like that, weigh it. Once you're done, put it back on, has a little locking feature, boom. Put your turkey bag or your vacuum seal bag over the top, pour it in. Straightforward, nice, saves a lot of time, and it saves a lot of mess. Yeah, so this is gonna be your basic cleanup section. I mean, you're gonna start off, I always like to use gloves. Obviously, you know, sometimes you're gonna get more resin content on your fingers, gonna get more resin content on your gloves, so you're gonna start to change them out. I just prefer to use gloves, especially if I'm using a vacuum sealer or turkey bags or anything like that. Isopropyl alcohol, always great to have on hand. I mean, I don't grow in my apartment anymore, but I still have like a gallon of isopropyl alcohol just for cleaning up around the apartment. Humboldt hand soap, I still use this just in my, like, I think in my bathroom, I have a bar of Humboldt hand soap. This is a really nice soap. Not only do, as cheesy as it sounds, it smells really good. From all their varieties smell really good, but it really helps if you have something like resin on your fingers that you need to get off. It has a nice kind of grain that kind of digs in and just cuts out all that immediately. SOS, another tried and true brand that helps get any type of resin off of your fingers. And then for when you're cleaning your scissors at the end of your harvest or even, you know, mid-harvest, mid-trim, anything like that, you're gonna wanna use a scissor magic. Always want to make sure your scissors are clean, not gunking up or anything like that. That's going to mess up the actual trim of your leaves. It's just going to, you know, lower production all around. Try to have as much cleanliness as possible. Well, that's it for me over here at Monster Gardens. All of these products and many more just like it are available at monstergardens.com, or you can stop by our Sonoma County location. Thanks for stopping by. Go ahead and hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button for us. And if you have any products that you'd like us to feature on Grow Closet, go ahead and comment down below.